Welcome. I'm Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager for Microsoft Fabric. In this video, you'll see several Microsoft Fabric platform demos. We'll start with a demo of the Variable Library, a new item type in Microsoft Fabric that allows users to define and manage variables at the workspace level. Next, we'll show how navigating through your data got more efficient using the OneLake catalog. Wow, that's exciting. And finally, we'll wrap up the platform demos by demonstrating how security teams can use DLP policies to meet security and compliance requirements for all the sensitive data in the cloud. Let's kick things off with Lee and the Variable Library. Lee, take it away.
We are excited to introduce a new feature that allows you to enhance your workload pages by including video content from YouTube or Vimeo. This feature makes it easier for you to provide visual and instructional content directly to the workload page, offering a more engaging and informative experience for your users. To embed a video, head to the workload sample on GitHub and see how to add to the product. JSON file the new slide media property and include the video link. This seamless integration supports various use cases, such as tutorials, demonstrations, helping you to effectively communicate complex information. We believe this addition will greatly benefit your workflow and improve the overall user experience. Thank you for your continued efforts and happy developing.
With tags, you get the ability to apply additional metadata to your items, giving you more flexibility in how you structure and manage your data estate. And because tags will enhance the searchability of data, they'll boost the efficiency of search and discovery across your organization and the success rates of your users. Let's see how this new feature will work. First, tenant admins create a list of publicly available tags, which everyone in your organization can then consume. Creating tags is quick and straightforward, and you can add them in a batch or one by one. Once your tags are created, they can be applied by data owners to add relevant context to their items. And we've added a new tab to the item settings to enable this, where you'll see the tags already applied to items and can also browse and select additional tags that might fit. Now, data consumers in your org can use tags to discover relevant content in Fabric, whether by filtering the list of items using one or more tags, exploring the information on applied tags in a list, by hanging on the tags icon from within the lineage view, or by clicking on the flyout card to view more details on an item. Best of all, anyone can now use tags to search for new content in Fabric. Relevant tags will show up in a dedicated column on the search results page, so it's clear where you get your results.
Working with Fabric data in Excel just got easier. We're excited to introduce the integration of the OneLake catalog and the modern Get Data experience in Excel for Windows. Now, you can seamlessly access your lakehouse or warehouse right from Excel. No complex connections, no extra steps. With just a few clicks, you can open the Get Data view and connect to your Fabric assets directly from the Home tab or a dedicated OneLake catalog section, making it effortless to find and access the data you need. Simply select your data set, choose the exact table you want, and start working with your data in Excel instantly. This integration is currently available to customers in the M365 Insiders program, beta channel, with a broader rollout coming soon. Get ready to streamline your workflow and unlock insights faster with the OneLake catalog in Excel.
Welcome to SaaS Decision Builder on Microsoft Fabric. Get started by selecting SaaS Decision Builder from the Microsoft Workload Hub to access a brand new lightweight decision intelligence solution from SaaS. SaaS Decision Builder is designed to help you translate insights into action using your Fabric One Lake data to construct business rules, design and monitor decisions, and govern them using native Fabric integration. Powerful business logic can be easily designed using the analyst-friendly interface by both reusing existing govern rules or by creating new if-then-else logic from the intuitive interface. Using Decision Builder, analysts and developers access different resources, including Python code, to design, test, and run decisions in a secure manner. Users can quickly connect OneLake data and their decisions to rapidly deploy their business logic to operational systems as jobs within the Fabric ecosystem. Jobs are natively integrated as part of the Fabric monitoring hub, so business analysts have a single, unified view into pipeline jobs and their status. So what's next? Talk to SAS and Microsoft and start turning your insights into action.
We're excited to introduce a powerful update to the OneLake catalog. With this release, the catalog now supports all item types, including Power BI reports, dashboards, metrics, real-time dashboards, the new organizational apps, and more, bringing all your insights together in one place. To help business users find what matters most, you can now filter the catalog by the insights category, making it easier to focus on relevant content and make informed decisions quickly and efficiently. For even more precision, the catalog offers multiple filtering options, allowing you to filter by the workspaces you have permissions for, items you own, trusted and endorsed assets, and favorite items for quick access. You can also filter your content by domains and applied tags to refine your search. Explore the new insights category in the OneLake catalog and take your data analysis experience to the next level.
KQL databases in Microsoft Fabric enable real-time interactive analytics that empower organizations to quickly query and gain insights from massive datasets. With this release, we're allowing organizations to detect the upload of sensitive data to KQL DBs and trigger automatic risk remediation actions using Purview data loss prevention policies. In my real-time intelligence events house, a KQL DB was created, but now I'm going to update it by uploading data. Once it is updated, it'll trigger the evaluation of the DLP policy to look for violations as were defined by my security admin. You can see here that the data I uploaded contains credit card numbers which are considered sensitive. Once the data is updated in OneLake, it will trigger the policy to scan the KQL DB, and when it discovers the sensitive information, it will show me a policy tip. In the workspace or in OneLake catalog, you can see an indication that produces a hover card, and by clicking on more details, you can see exactly what rules were violated and any other guidelines the security admin decides to use in the policy tip. With DLP for KQL DBs, you have further visibility into the sensitive information that may be uploaded into Fabric, allowing you to take immediate remediation actions. Thank you.
In this demo, we'll show you how you can create powerful solutions with the new variable library item and data pipelines. You can also add alternative value sets, which will allow you to set variables to match your release stages in your CICD solution. Now, let's use some of these variables in a data pipeline. For example, in my get metadata activity, I've set some dynamic content for my file path. In the expression builder, you'll see a new tab for library variables. Use these like you would a parameter or any other variable. I click on my folder, and you'll see a new library variable expression is populated. Now, let's run this pipeline and see what happens. After successfully running, you'll see that the input folder path shows that the files are coming from variable library dev and the dev folder, which is exactly what we set as our default value. Now, let's see how we can use this with CICD. After opening my deployment pipeline, you can see that I have three stages set up: development, test, and production. I'll deploy all my items from dev to test. In my variable library, I'll make sure to set the test value set as active. Now, when I run my pipeline, you'll see that the file path has been updated to variable library test and the test folder, without me having to modify my pipeline at all.
Those demos were pretty awesome, right? Hit us up with your number one takeaway. And if you've got any questions, drop them where? In the comments below. Is there a specific demo you want to see next month? Let us know. And remember to like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on all the latest updates from Microsoft Fabric.